Hello friends, welcome to Live Fair Do Mathematics. In this video, we are going to understand group theory by solving examples. Okay, we will learn definition and then learn how to apply this definition to solve group theory problems. So first, we have taken a problem. The problem is chosen from the famous book of Schema-Pagge Higher Algebra, and this is from exercise 8. So let us see the problem. The problem says, this is question number 1, examine if the following systems are groups. So we have to examine or check if the following given 3 systems are groups or not. Okay, so we have to prove this. So first system is given as G, this binary operation. Okay, so let me say about this first. So this notation is the notation of a binary operation. Okay, so this is basically a binary operation or composition. Okay, now we will read this operation. Whenever this notation comes, we will read this as compose. We will say compose. Okay, so this is my notation. So Z compose, we will read this as Z compose. Okay, so basically this is a binary operation or binary composition. Okay, so Z compose, where A compose B equals to A plus B plus 1, AB belongs to Z. If this mathematical system is group or not, we have to check. Then again, we have to check if R star compose, where A compose B equals to modulus of AB, where AB belongs to R star. And what is R star? R stars mean R difference singleton 0. Similarly, Z cross Z compose, where AB compose CD is defined as A plus C, B plus D, A plus C, B plus D, and where AB and CD belongs to Z cross Z. Okay, so we have to check this. So look, we have to prove this, that if this system is group or not. So for that, we have to show that this system satisfies all the conditions of the definition of a group. Okay, so we have to first know the definition of a group. So what is the definition of a group? So let G be a non-empty set. Okay, then we will restrict this set, or we will define group on this set. Okay, so G be a non-empty set satisfying the condition. If G satisfies these 4 conditions, then we will say that G is a group. So what are those conditions? The first condition is G is closed under the binary operation this. Okay, so first of all, G should be closed under the binary operation. The second condition is this binary operation is associative. Okay, and the third condition is there exists an element E in G such that E composition E equals to A for all A in G. Okay, so this is basically identity E. Okay, E compose A equals to A, that means E behaves as identity. And for each element A in G, there exists an element A dash in G such that A dash compose A equals to E. So basically this A dash is the inverse. So what are those four conditions? So to remember those four conditions, the short process is, first of all, G should be closed under the given binary operation. Second condition, the binary operation should be associative. So closed, associative. The third condition, the mathematical condition should contain an identity. Okay, and the fourth condition is it should contain inverse. Okay, now identity and inverse will be unique, so that is another theorem to prove. So we will may go later, but for now, to remember, you should know that G be a non-empty set. If G satisfies these 4 conditions, then G will be a group. So what are those conditions? G should be closed under the binary operation, the binary operation should be associative, and the system should contain a unit, an identity, and an inverse. Okay, so let us check the first problem. Okay, now the first problem gives, look here, Z compose, where A compose B equals to A plus B plus 1. So we are writing here again. So this is the mathematical system Z compose, where A compose B is defined as A plus B plus 1 for all A B belongs to Z. Okay, now look, suppose we have taken AB from Z. So we are the first condition, that is closedness. We are checking closedness. Okay. So take A, B from Z. Now if we choose A, B from Z, then under this binary operation, A compose B. What will be A compose B? A compose B will give A plus B plus 1. Now as A, B are integers, then since A is integers, A and B is integer, A plus B is an integer. Again, if we add 1 with this, then it will again be an integer because A, B and 1 are all integers and the sum of integers is again an integer. Okay, so A plus B plus 1 belongs to Z. That is, we have taken two elements and then those elements under this binary operation gives birth to an another integers. Okay, so this system is closed. Now we will check the associativity. So to check associativity, so we will check associativity. Okay, so for that, look, we have to show that A compose B compose C equals to A compose B compose C. This is the definition of associativity. So we have to show this. Now first, let us do the left hand side. The left hand side is A compose B compose C. Now what is A compose B? By this definition, A compose B is A plus B plus 1 and this is again compose with C. Now consider this again as like this, A, consider this whole system as X, then this becomes X compose C. Then what is X compose C? X compose C is X plus C plus 1. Now put X, X is A plus B plus 1, A plus B plus 1 plus C plus 1. So basically now this becomes A plus B plus C and 1 plus 1 equals to 2. Okay, so the left hand side gives this. Now let us write the right hand side. Right hand side is A compose B compose C. Now A compose, what is B compose C? B compose C, if we put, so according to this definition of A compose B, B compose C will be B plus C plus 1. Okay, now again consider this B plus C plus 1 as Y. Okay, then what we will have? We have A compose Y. Again A compose Y is A plus Y plus 1. Now put in place of Y, B plus C plus 1. So A plus B plus C plus 1 and then plus 1. So now we have A plus B plus C and 1 plus 1 is 2. Look, A compose B compose C is A plus B plus C plus 2 and A compose B compose C is again A plus B plus C plus 2. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So A compose B compose C is equals to A compose B compose C. So this system is associative. Now we will check for identity. Okay, now suppose E is the identity. So now we check for identity. Okay, now suppose E is the identity, then what we have to show? That E compose A equals to A. Okay, so let us find this identity. Now if E is the identity, then we have to find this identity. So if E is the identity, then E compose A equals to A. Now what is E compose A? According to this definition, in place of A we put E and in place of B we put A, then we will have E compose A will be E plus A plus 1 equals to A. Okay, now this means E equals to A minus 1 minus A. So plus A minus A cancels out. This gives A equals to minus 1, E equals to minus 1. So this is the identity. Okay, now we will again check that indeed this is the identity. Then we have to show that if this is the identity, then minus 1 compose A will be A. What is minus 1 compose A? Minus 1 plus A plus 1 plus 1 minus 1 cancels out. This is equals to A. So yes, minus 1 is the identity. Okay, so this was our back calculation again. So now we have shown that this system has an identity. Now we will check for the inverse. So we have, so for inverse, A dash compose A will be identity. What is A dash? This is the inverse of A. Now what is E? E is minus 1, we have already got here. Then what is A dash compose A? According to the definition, this is A dash plus A plus 1. So this is equals to minus 1. then what is a dash? So a dash is minus 1, then take this plus 1 to right hand side, this will give minus 1, this plus a to right hand side, this will give minus a. So this implies a dash equals to minus 2 minus a. So this system consists an inverse 2. So this system satisfies all these 4 conditions. So this system is indeed a group. Okay, so yes, this system is a group. So option 1 is true. Now we have to show that this system is not a group, or we have to show that this system is a group. So we have to examine basically. Now look, we will show you that this system is not a group. For that, if this is not a group, then this will violate at least one of these 4 conditions. Okay, so you have to think which condition will be violated. Okay, so for that you have to give a counter example. Okay, so the group 3 given by R star compose, sorry, this is not group, we have to examine if this is group or not. So the system R star compose 0, where A compose B is given by modulus of AB. Okay, so now let us check if that is a group or not. So A compose B is defined as modulus of AB, where A, B belongs to R star. R star is R minus 0. Okay, now if this is a group, then this will satisfy this condition. Condition 3, that is, there will be an element E in G such that E compose A equals to A. Okay, now take an element minus 5. Minus 5 belongs to R star. So we want to show that there exists an element E such that minus 5 compose E equals to minus 5. Okay, so this condition. Okay, so no, sorry, we have to write this as this. So E compose minus 5 equals to minus 5. Look here, E compose A equals to A. So we have taken A as minus 5. Then what is E compose minus 5? According to this definition, A compose B equals to modulus AB. This will be modulus of E into minus 5, that is equals to minus 5. Now mod A into B is mod A into mod B, that is equals to minus 5. This implies mod E into 5 equals to minus 5. This implies mod E equals to minus 5 by 5, that is implies mod E equals to minus 1. But since modulus of any real number cannot be negative, so this is not possible. Okay, so basically this system has no identity, that is, there does not exist any E in G such that E compose A equals to A holds. So this system does not have any identity. So this system is not a group. So this system is not a group. Now my friends, I have shown these two problems. Now imitate this argument as I have shown in the problem 1. If you are imitate those arguments, you can be able to prove this option. Okay, so this will be a group, and you have to check that by imitating the arguments as I have shown in option 1. This problem and these problems are same, just imitate the arguments. Okay my friend, hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed the video, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to share the video with your friends. Stay tuned with us, we'll come back shortly with this kind of video again. And if you have any problem or any query, please let me know in the comment section. If you want any video that you have problem with your own problems, then please let me know in the comment section. Thank you.